I sold my soul a good price out of sight. My hoe got talent, right? Whole squad ran.
Alright, what's going on, guys? Let's talk about Modern Warfare. And in the background, we're just going to have some of that 4K gameplay that Infinity Ward dropped last week. Yeah, let's scope. Alright, start off, let's talk about the new minimap thing. For me, I think that's going way too far in the realistic mode. I think Call of Duty has a fine line that you can't cross when it comes to realistic. That crossed it. I think Call of Duty still needs to be Call of Duty, and Call of Duty is just minimap. I mean, you have to have the minimap. Or it's just not Call of Duty.
We have a personal radar drone.
I mean, Call of Duty's always had a minimap. I think it's just the. It just always needs to be this from now on, here on out. Second thing is, like, if you really want to play, like, a realistic shooter, I think everybody would be playing Insurgency Sandstorm. That is the most realistic thing that, like, first-person shooter out there at the moment, I believe. And if you really want to play realistic things, you go to that one. But I don't think Call of Duty needs to be exactly like that. Talk about the microtransactions. Obviously, Black Ops 4 is an absolute disaster when it comes to microtransactions. I mean, they made it pay to win, like, hugely. I mean, you literally had to drop $200 just to get the things that you want. Like, that's just, that should be it. I think it should be more like BO2, where you pay $2 for a camo and you get exactly what you pay for every time. That's just how it should be. Not some of this complete bullcrap of supply drops and then. Like, you put the guns in the supply drops only, and you gotta, and then you want to get one thing, and then you only get the emotes and charms and all that bullcrap in there. Obviously, let's talk about some good things. The gunsmith in Modern Warfare is absolutely insane. I think it's gonna add the coolest customization things possible. The gunplay still looks like Call of Duty. So that's a good sign. Didn't go too far in that one. It's obviously just going to be a little bit more tactical this year than any other Call of Duty. I think it might be a little more slow pace once the game fully releases, but we'll see. Last thing, but not least, killstreaks. I think it was Nilsday that uploaded some chopper gunner gameplay. And it looked kind of weak. I mean, it looked like he had a square on the guy X for like 10 seconds in order to kill him. And I don't know. I think that kill streaks, if you earn a kill streak that large, it should be able to at least kill the guy. I mean, Modern Warfare 2 kill streaks were absolutely perfect in my opinion. Like, they were fun to use. Chopper Gunner was the best thing in the game. In AC-130, you could literally couldn't take it down. Oh, we need to go back to that. I want to add one more thing. When it comes to microtransactions for Modern Warfare, obviously Sony, Microsoft, and I think it was Nintendo just agreed to they have to like disclose the percentage of like your chances of actually getting like a good item out of supply drop. Obviously that's huge. I don't think it's going to change anything in my opinion, but it's a step in the right direction. FIFA 19 actually has this system in their FIFA 19 game right now. I'll put a screenshot of that right now. And you can see that like it says like 6% chance of actually getting a high-rated player out of this pack. I'm sure it'll be somewhat similar to that when it comes to Modern Warfare next year. And it'll say like probably like 10% chance of getting a weapon or something or legendary. I don't know how the heck they're going to put this in, but I'm sure that supply drops will be a thing in Modern Warfare, and there's just nothing we can do about it, unfortunately. So that's the last thing I needed to say. Again, please hit that like and subscribe button below. Enjoy.